game theory is interesting because you can use that with a set of statistics. And so we can look at all sorts of things, like if you've just had a big win, you might have two or three losers. For example, that would be appropriate with a trend following type of system. Of course, you need to know the statistics for your own individual game. Then you go into your distribution or your consolidation type of phase. So after the market's just had a big move, a large standard deviation move, for example, like we might have just seen in the metals or perhaps the grains, it's only natural for them to enter a prolonged choppy period. A market profile terminology might call this bracketing as we start to form a trading range. So if you understand that the strategies can be completely opposite for these two types of environments, a trend follower, if you've just had a big win, would be a lot more reticent to aggressively take the next signal, because he would understand that with game theory, you know, after one big win, you might have two or three losers, and so forth and so forth. Same thing, if you've just followed a extended period of consolidation and choppiness, that doesn't guarantee that you're going to get a big trend out of that, but those are the types of environments that can lead to a big win. So if you understand this inherently from a statistical standpoint, it might help a trader stand on a more even emotional keel. For example, if they see that they've just had two or three losers with their system, they should start to feel excited that the next one might be a big win, you see? So we can use it to help temper our own psychology and keep an even temper with this stuff. If you've just had a big win, then you need to be a little bit more conservative and say, ah, you know, we're perhaps due for a little bit of choppiness, and I need to temper my bullishness, because the big wins can be as equally debilitating as the losses in our business. Losses are debilitating, big wins are debilitating, and long flat periods are debilitating. So if you try to put things in a framework of game theory, statistics, how your system or how your approach works, I think that it can help counterbalance some of these psychological highs and lows that individuals tend to feel. And another problem, too, is that people don't know when to switch gears. It's very difficult. So when we're in a strong trending environment, it's very easy to trade the continuation patterns. Just buy the dip, buy the dip, buy the dip, the little bull flags all the way up. It's hard once you start to enter that trading range or that rotation type of distribution for people to switch gears. And then when you're sitting there buying the bull flags in a trading range, it's not going to have the same type of outcome. So you need to have some way to quantify that you've changed environments or recognize you know, when the trend has stopped and you're in a different type of environment that is going to demand a different type of strategy, even if it's just standing in cash for a while.